The other important thing is the throttle on the machine. There's a lot of people that just run it wide open. I mean, and then they say they're saving the clutch. But the throttle on the machine is there for a reason, just like it is in the vehicle. To go faster, to go slower. Sometimes your first pass, depending on the size of the floor, you might want to go over it maybe half throttle. And as the floor gets hotter, harder, you speed the throttle up. But when you get close to your edges, you want to throttle down so you're not whipping stuff out onto your edges. And then when you get into the wetter stuff, you want to throttle down so the pan machine just floats through it. Because if you got it throttled up, and you throttle right through the wet stuff, what you're doing is you're digging a hole, you're throwing stuff all over, you're getting the machine all dirty. And that's not good. It just makes more work for everyone. But I'm going to make a couple passes and show you my technique. You can see, like, when I come back to the edge here, I throttle down and I maneuver the machine so that just one pan kind of dips out there instead of both pans coming back, stopping, and then you get your stop and go mark, then you move over, then you go forward. What I'm doing is I'm coming back into it, I'm throttling down and just kind of floating, pulling the cream away from the edge so it doesn't pile. And then as I get back out towards the body of the slab, I straighten the machine out. I do the same thing when I'm going into the fresher concrete tube. I throttle down, I just kind of float through it, and then come back down, and as you get into the harder stuff, you throttle up.